بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه ولاه وسلم تسليما كثيرا ما بعد we continue with سورة الرحمن سورة number 55 this beautiful سورة of Allah عز وجل telling the humans and the jinn talking to human and jinn so one we are recognizing that there is another world hidden world the world of jinn which is parallel to our world if you want to call it that way or you want to look at it that way there is another creation of Allah we do not know what they do or how they do it but they exist so the jinn exists and I don't want to talk about jinn now and scare everybody but the idea is that the jinn exist and the only thing about jinn that makes all this superstition and stories about them that are hidden and anything hidden that you do not see you have a fertile imagination right but the jinn like us they have their strength they have their weakness not necessarily same strengths and weaknesses but they do have their strength and weakness they have the believers and disbelievers they have the disobedient and the obedient they have the good and the bad and they have the smart and the not the so smart and everything and there is like kind of a covenant with Allah Azza wa Jalla not to harm the humans and like a covenant from the humans also not to harm al-jinn or not to cross the limit so if one of them crosses then it becomes a problem Allah give us the ruqya Allah give us to recite the Quran certain ayat Allah give us these protections so if one of them transgress Quran will burn them and punish them And if one of the humans transgress, you bring also problems to yourself. وَأَنَّهُ كَانَ رِجَالٌ مِنَ الْإِنسِ يَعُذُونَ بِرِجَالٍ مِنَ الْجِنِّ فَزَادُوهُمْ رَهْقًا Some of the humans seek the help of the jinn and they increase their problems and not brought them help. You know? So anyways, this is just when you read Surah Ar-Rahman, you know that you are not alone in this universe. So you know, when people said, oh, it's unbelievable that we are alone. Who said that we are alone? You know, we know. That we're not alone. Look at something we do not see, coronavirus, you know. We're not alone. Something we do not see, and as weak as it can come, scientifically speaking, and it is making the whole world panic. So you're not alone. Of course you're not alone. There is the world of jinn, there is the world of viruses, there is the world of animals, there is the world of the seen and the world of the unseen within the physical realm. And then there are other realm, the realm of the angels, the realm of the jinn, and we don't know, Allah knows what. يعني وَرَبُّكَ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيَخْتَارُ Your Lord, سبحانه وتعالى, He creates whatever He wishes. وَيَخْلُقُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ And He creates what you do not know. So that basically answers all the questions. So if anybody tell you there might be parallel universe, might be. There might be other universes, might be. There may be another life in another planet or another galaxy or another system. Why not? So there may be another complete system with different concept of time and space and place. Okay, yeah. Until you discover that, I'm not negating the possibility. Negating the possibility means you are limiting Qudra of Allah. But is it there? Are we going to act differently? What should we do? Until you discover, then we'll just keep what we have, you know. Where Allah ordered us. So what Allah ordered us with. But it does not change our faith or our belief that Allah is able to do what He wants. Now, after the punishment, after Allah Azza wa Jal spoke about the kuffar, about the mushrikeen, about the signs of the day of judgment, and about the jinn, if they try to get to the sky and the heavens and try to listen, Allah Azza wa Jalla give the glad tidings. Surah Ar-Rahman, Allah Azza wa Jalla give the mushrikeen first and then believers. Surah Al-Waqi'ah, as we'll see later, Allah Azza wa Jalla gives the believers first then the mushrikeen. So it's like, mushrikeen at their punishment, then believers, then believers, then mushrikeen. So you have the two surahs as if they are one unit, and that's also how the Quran is related. All the surahs and ayats related to each other. وَلِمَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ جَنَّتَانِ. Allah Azza wa Jalla did not say, and those who believed. Allah said, the reason why they believed. Allah did not say, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. In this surah, I'm talking about this surah, because other surahs, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, those who believe and عَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, كَانَتْ لَهُمْ جَنَّةُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ نُزُولًا. Allah gave them firdaus. So because they believe and they عَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Here Allah Azza wa Jalla says, why they عَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. لأنه خاف مقام ربه, out of the fear of the status of their Lord سبحانه وتعالى. So whatever they do, part of the iman is there with you when you do every action. And that's my argument all the time when people say, do not judge me with my heart and all of that. So Allah عز وجل here, he says لمن خاف مقام ربه جنتان, that those who fear Allah and his status, they have two jannah. You cannot take that ayah, nobody can take that ayah and say, because of my fear of Allah, I enter Jannah. Then you don't pray? You don't give zakah? You say, yeah, I have to pray and give zakah. What if you just believe and don't pray and don't do zakah? Then you'll not have the two Jannah. Two Jannah? Not only one, not two? So what is the point of all those who are doing all this? You'll be equal to them without, then Allah is not fair. So if you say that, only my fear to my Lord is in my heart and it will get me to Jannah, that means you are putting yourself equal to those who pray and do all kind of activity. And that in itself is accusation to Allah that he's not fair. Yani he is telling you, okay, you cannot do anything and you enter Jannah, while these people are doing all this, go through all these problems and through all this hardship because of their prayer and all of that, and still they will go to Jannah like you. So Allah is not fair, astaghfirullah, if you do that. And if you say that doing the deeds only physically, and belief is not important, means all these munafiqeen will go to Jannah as well. So still Allah is not fair. Why? Because Allah Azza wa Jalla said, munafiqeen, they pray, but their intention is not right. They show Islam and they hide kufr. So if you talk about the physical seen activities only as a reason of Jannah, munafiqeen will enter. And if you say that the niyyah only will admit people to Jannah, means the believers, now you are making dhulm to them. And anybody can say that, I can claim that. So that's why it's both. So sometimes Allah said, أَمَنُوا عَمِلُوا الصَّلَحَاتِ. Sometimes He said, خَافَ مَقَمْ. Sometimes Allah said, because of their niyyah they enter Jannah, because of their amal enter Jannah. That means because of both. Because Allah cannot contradict Himself. Allah will not contradict Himself. You cannot say that. Which one? Both. يعني Allah Azza wa Jalla says here, because of their fear to their Lord, they enter Jannah. Means they did not do anything. Actually, logically speaking, anybody who fears his Lord, it will lead them to act in a certain way. Has to. Yani when you say, I am afraid of darkness, what are you doing then? Next step. You turn light. If you can turn the light on, you turn the light on. Or at least you say, I want the light to be on, otherwise I will stay afraid. So your fear will lead you to do something, for sure. So وَلِمَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ جَنَّتَانِ. Two Jannah. Not one. طبعاً some of the explanation, why two gardens? Because everyone has two places in Jannah, has a place in Jannah and a place in hellfire. You know the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when a person dies and put in the grave, Allah shows him his place in hellfire, said that it was your place in your hellfire if you disobeyed. But Allah, now the ayah, there is an empty space that of the believer, for the believers in hellfire, empty. And there is empty space for the disbeliever in Jannah. So يعني, Abu Jahl has his place in Jannah, another believer will take. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, Allah saved him from hellfire by his belief. So Abu Jahl will take both in Jannah. Will take his original assigned space plus the space that Allah saved the believer from. يُضَاعَفُ لَهُمُ الْعَذَابِ. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, يُضَاعَفُ لَهُ الْعَذَابِ. the punishment will be twice. And in here in Jannah, Jannatan. So you take this Jannah, double, mashallah. فَبِأَيَّ أَلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَ تُكَذِّبَانِ. With what of the Allah's favors you deny? Of course we don't. Allah described this Jannatan. ذَوَاتَ أَفْنَانِ. ذَوَاتَ means the two Jannah. That, Al-Jannah, that, Afnan. Al-Jannah, that, Afnan. Al-Jannatan, Thawata, Afnan. Grammatically speaking, يعني. Jannah wa Jannah, Jannatan. That wa that, Thawata, Afnan. Al-Afnan is the branches. When you say Jannah has branches, that means it has lots of trees, and the branches has lots of leaves, the leaves has lots of fruits. So Allah mentioned something means lots of branches. What does lots of branches mean? Shade and fruit. When the tree has more branches, what does it mean? It means more of benefit. More benefit. ذَوَاتَ أَفْنَانِ فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. How a person fears Allah? By abandoning the disobedience and doing the obedience. And why? What is fear? Fear is always about the future. Huh? Fear also about what? Future. So because you are afraid to get late to work in the morning, what do? You wake up early to avoid the traffic. So you're afraid of tomorrow's traffic, so you wake up early to avoid the traffic. I hope the idea is clear. So they are afraid of Allah's punishment, so they avoid what leads to His anger and do what leads to His pleasure, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So فيهما عينان تجريان سبحان الله تجريان يعني running, flowing. عينان يعني two springs of water. In Jannah, Allah said Jannah تجري من تحتها الأنهار, rivers flowing beneath. طيب, by Jannah is above the Jannah of someone, and he has rivers and I have rivers, how يعني? Again, the law of gravity and the law of conceptualizing things is completely different. It can run right to left, left to right, up, down, down, up, diagonal, whatever it is. It runs the way they want it. The law is completely different of Jannah. فيهما عينان تجريان. Some of the ulama said, Allah mentioned in the Quran, ومزاجه من تسنيم في سورة المنافقين. They said one of the springs is called تسنيم, and the other one called عينا فيها تسمى سلسبيلا في سورة الإنسان. So they said التسنيم والسلسبيل, those are the two springs mentioned in سورة الرحمن here. فيهما عينان تجريان. فيهما من كل فاكهة زوجان. طبعا after everyone فبأي آلاء ربكم تكذبان comes relating to this ni'mah, as we mentioned in the beginning of the surah, that each one of فَبَيَا لَرَبِكُمْ تُكَذِّبَانِ is not a mere repetition, it is more to connect with the ni'mah itself. So when I tell you, you are going to leave this house and go to such and such house, do you understand? Yes. And once you reach to the house, you knock on the door, do you understand? Oh, you understand the part of knocking on the door. Then when he opens to you and asks you such and such, you said something, do you understand? So now, do you understand? It's not mere repetition here. Don't tell me, you already asked me once. Yeah, I asked you about leaving to his place. Now, about knocking the door. Now, about talking to him. Now, about what if. I hope it is understood. يعني. So when you say, فَبَأَيَّ رَبِّكُمْ تُكَذِّبَانِ, after every ni'mah, it is about that ni'mah. That ni'mah here, isn't that enough for you? After seeing this one ni'mah, which of the bounties of Allah do you disbelieve? So how many times Allah repeat that? That means argument is done. The argument is done. And one of those ni'mah only would be enough to say, Ya Allah, I will not disbelieve in any of your ni'mah. One ni'mah only. Imagine now how many ni'mahs Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned, how many times it's mentioned. So that's why I want everybody to understand this seemingly repeated ayah, it's not repeated. So Allah Azza wa Jal reminding us after each one, it's like an escalation. Like you're going up and going up and going up. By the end of Surah Ar-Rahman, you should reach to the ultimate faith level. Means whatever Allah says, سَمِّعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا, I'm done. That's enough. One of those would be enough for me to believe, Ya Allah. So Allah Azza wa Jalla said, "Min kulli fakiha," from every fakiha, every fruit, they have two types. Zawjan. Dry and moist, some of the ulama said. Dry and moist. You have fig, you have the fig which is fresh and stored. Some people sometimes you like the dry fruit. Yeah, you fresh fruit, you have mango, but you want to eat the dry mango. So the both are there, zawjan. The way you like it. The way you like the fruit. فيهما من كل فاكهة زوجان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان متكئين على فرش بطائنها من استبرق. فرش is the plural of فراش. فراش is like your bed, the place where you sleep. Not سرير, because now they say سرير in Arabic and they mean bed. But سرير in Quran and classical Arabic means the throne. I mean the part of the throne that the king sits on. That is sarir. Kursi is not the chair I'm sitting on right now. That kursi is where I put my foot. It is the footstool. I mentioned that many times before. So kursi is where the king put his footstool. And what he sits on is sarir. And the pieces of furniture is called al-arsh. It's called what? Al-arsh. Al-arsh has sarir and has kursi and has other pieces of furniture. That's al-arsh. Arsh. So in Yawm al-Qiyamah in Jannah, people have arsh too. Surur mutaqabilin, each one in his sarir. And subhanAllah, in this world, kings fight. They cannot be two kings in one piece of land. But in Jannah, you are sitting there and your garden there, and somebody sitting in front of you, and his garden is huge also. But I don't know how you're going to be sitting in front of each other. هذا علم عند الله عز وجل. متقابلين يعني. So the kings is like in a meeting room and nobody is feeling threatened from anybody else. Jannah. Allah take all this grudge and envy and selfish, being selfish and all of that, Allah take it away from their heart. So their furush, plural of firash, means the place where they sit, or they sleep, متكئين, reclining, على فرش, بطائنها, the stuffing of it, is استبرق, حرير. استبرق is the thick silk. سندس is the smooth silk. بطائنها من استبرق. يعني the inside of it is silk. So the part that above is sundus, the part is down, or the part which is inside is istabraq. على فرش بطائنها من استبرق وجن الجنتين دان. The fruit is so close to them. You go on a tree of berries, or mulberry, or raspberry or something like that, and you find always the juicy nice ones far from you. Why? Because this is far. That's why it's ripe big, because nobody touches. And so the one close to you, always the ripe one is hard to reach. في الدنيا بس. أما في الجنة is close to you. Then it will, you look at the tree, you find the branch coming at you to pick and enjoy. وجن الجنتين then. دانٍ يعني من الدنو يعني coming down. وجن الجنتين دان. If you are reclining, it gets you. You're sitting, based on subhanAllah. You're gonna get it. Nothing is gonna be far from you. Otherwise, this is an effort. And Jannah does not have effort in it. This dunya is the dunya, the dar of effort, the place of effort. Jannah is the place of reward. No, should be no effort at all. وجن الجنتين دان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان. Then Allah Azza wa Jal says فيهن قاصرات الطرف. حور العين. حور العين females. That's خلاص يعني. I don't want to get into that discussion. And we talked about it a lot. So listen to all the lectures. We're not going to keep repeating this issue. Yeah, man, woman, all of this is here. Okay, when we go there, inshallah, our sisters, بإذن الله تعالى, will be the most satisfied, the happiest. You do not need a man to be satisfied in Jannah. Sisters, you do not need. You need Allah to be pleased with you, Azza wa Jal. If Allah is pleased with you and you enter Jannah, this negative feeling is not there. So our discussion here has no point. Our discussion based on a negative feeling itself. Why you have this and I don't have this. That's it. Do you think Allah spoke about every single aspect in Jannah in the Quran? No. Why? I want this. Like he has this, I want this. That is the dunya part. In Jannah, Allah Azza wa Jal, his ni'mah is to be satisfied beyond feeling that you're needy. You enter Jannah and you feel needy, means you're not in Jannah. Logically speaking, the argument does not have a place, actually. Because all the argument is a negative feeling, it's inequality, and why he has something I do not have. If a person, you think a person inside of Jannah was like that, that means Allah is not just. There has to be no feeling like this in Jannah. So that the feeling of satisfaction in Jannah, that is the na'im. This is just description for us to think, to be motivated. That's all. When you enter Jannah, everybody is satisfied with whatever they get, and they feel that nobody is above them. Subhanallah. For here, all these degrees is for us to compete. But once we enter Jannah, khalas, that's it. Do you have to compete because we cannot get rid of that feeling here. I don't want to go deeper in philosophy, but leave it alone. So, الحور العين, Allah Azza Jal here, he is saying that قاصراتو, and that is a female only exclusive pronoun. When I said exclusive pronoun, means there is no possibility of even a young male kid in it, young male child. When you said مؤمنات, means females and female only. When you say مؤمنين, can be males and females or males only, but cannot be females only. So when you say مؤمنات, مسلمات, قانتات, تائبات, عابدات, سائحات, ثيبات, وأبكار, that's females only. سبحان الله. المؤمنين والمؤمنات, قانتين والقانتات, male, female, male, female. So here Allah عز وجل said فيهن, في الجنتين, in the two jannah, قاصرات, with it. He did not say قاصرين الطرف. قاصرين can be male and female. But قاصرات females only. الطرف لم يطمثون. يعني they do not look except to their spouses. Here in the dunya, سبحان الله, thoughts are thoughts. As long as you don't act upon them, خلاص, you don't say or act. The man, any man, in constant state of comparison between his wife and other women. And anybody tells you other than that is lying to you. And the woman is the same thing. Whether we like it or not. هذا طبيعة البشر. This is like the nature of things. But your iman brings you back. Said, لا, this is my husband, I should not go with that thought anymore. No, this is my wife, alhamdulillah, I'm pleased. She's making me happy, she's thinking of me, my children, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, ya Allah, give me barakah. You know, that's a believer. But the initial thought is there. You see another woman taking care of her husband better than your wife taking care of you, khalas, state of comparison. She sees a man, some of the women even will tell their husband, some of the men will tell their wives, look, see, in the time of engagement you used to be like this, but now look at you, look at them, like that. But في الجنة لا. في الجنة nobody is going to look at someone else. سبحان الله. So Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Ya Umar, I was in Jannah and I saw a palace. They told me this is a big palace. And I said, whose palace is this? And I saw like a woman like making wudu outside of the palace. في الجنة ونعيمها. Said, whose palace is this? She said, this is Umar. Umar ibn al-Khattab. So Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, I moved my face away so I don't look because I remember how jealous you are. So he said, Ya Rasulullah, I feel jealous from you. Even Rasulullah is respecting. Yani he's getting a peek into Jannah, which is still in the future, but he still said, no, Umar, see how respect. See how, that's how Rasulullah used to have fun and joke with his Sahaba and respect them, even with this high level ghaib. Of course, Sahaba will sacrifice anything for Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam when he's like that with them. Subhanallah. Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Allah, listen for us to how we treat our children and our youth and our students. Endless lessons. لم يطمثهن إنس قبلهم ولا جان. الطمث. The word الطمث. طمث or طمث here. يعني the bleeding. The bleeding of the women. When you said لم يطمثهن, it's a verb here. That means the no man took their virginity away. يعني they are your first, you are their first. الحور العين, you are their first. And Allah عز وجل said لم يطمثهن إنس قبلهم ولا جان. That means what? يعني في الجنة هيكون في جن also. الجن also in جنة. والجن also they have حور العين as well. And also here Allah عز وجل said they are not from the humans and they are not from the jinn. So don't think that حور العين are jinn women. Allah عز وجل said they were not spouses before to humans or jinn. So they are, you are their first. Allah created them for you in Jannah. حور العين. قاصرات الطرف, they only look to their husbands only, from ins or from jinn. So she is programmed in Jannah, just you. She does not see anybody else. Subhanallah! هذه نعمة من الله لا تكون إلا في الجنة. Only in Jannah. There is no one can tell anyone here, or husband tell his wife, don't look to any other man. Come on, يعني. Or a woman tell her husband, don't look to any other woman. يعني, what? Even if I'm blind, I'm going to hear and I'm going to talk to someone. بس في الجنة, that حور العين satisfied with her husband only. هذه نعمة عظيمة. That the husband feels that this is mine. No, nobody is going to look at her and she's not going to look at anybody. Gives another type of satisfaction. لم يطمثهن إنس قبلهم ولا جان. And also this is a proof that the jinn has marriages as well. And they have women who are married before and not married and virgin and not virgin and all of that. The same thing. Allah Azza wa Jal said, كأنهن الياقوت والمرجان. الياقوت is the ruby. Ruby. Ruby is red. Some of the scholars said, when you look at the real authentic precious stone, which is called ruby, you can see through. So clear. They said, حور العين is like that. So transparent and clear and beautiful and fragile like this. Or they blush with redness like the ruby. So both are like this. كأنهن الياقوت والمرجان. مرجان also is the coral, corals, which is red as well. So they have this beautiful color about them. كأنهن الياقوت والمرجان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان. هل جزاء الإحسان إلا الإحسان. يعني when you describe all of this, this is too much, you know. الدرجان normal food, normal stuff. لا, الله عز وجل, this is the exceeding the limit, and this is called إحسان because you did إحسان in your عبادة. Allah will do إحسان in the reward. هل جزاء الإحسان إلا الإحسان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان. سبحان الله. Somebody may ask, with the fear of Allah, what if a person make mistakes? They enter Jannah. If they repent, yes, of course. What if they don't repent? Oh, here is the question. One, they are in the mashia of Allah. If somebody commit a major sin, adultery or drinking or stealing or whatever, and they died without repenting. With repenting, we understand. Even shirk, with repenting, it is erased, right? But we're talking about somebody dies with the kabira. Even if they enter hellfire, eventually they'll enter Jannah. And they will have two Jannah. But this should not encourage people to do sin. Because now, after hearing this, it becomes insisting on the sin. Or challenging Allah Azza wa Jal. That's another problem now. That's another problem can make a person die insisting on the sin and become a mushrik or a kafir. So don't play with fire. But if somebody knows that they are wrong, but they are weak and all of that, they want to repent, but death came before they repent, that's what we're talking about. Not someone insisting. No. So they die, they are in the mashia of Allah. Insha'a azaba, insha'a ghafara lah. We know that Allah is able to say, I forgive you. You may have that. There is a risk. Or may put you in punishment. But eventually, will come out from hellfire anybody who has the weight of an atom of faith. Anybody who said, La ilaha illallah, just a statement, will come out from hellfire and go to Jannah. And this is the aqidah of Ahlul Sunnah. Again, some people say, but it doesn't make sense. Ya akhi, huwa Allah Azza wa Jal, you think Allah is another human being, yani, to make sense to you? Is Allah obligated to make sense to you? Yani, what is this? And I'm really surprised. You find a PhD this, PhD that, and think that Allah has to make sense to me. Yani, everything that Allah does or every rule, it has to make sense according to my limited logic of human beings. Ya akhi, subhanallah, wallahi, ajeeb. Yani, we think that a person increase in knowledge, increase in humbleness. Increase in humbleness and understanding the basic principle of Allah is not questioned on what he does. Especially from us. You are nobody compared to Allah to say, but it doesn't make sense. How come, you know? Person just say, La ilaha illallah, will enter Jannah. And a person doing all good here, but he's not a Muslim, will go to hellfire. Oh, yes, of course. Of course. All right. You like it or you don't like it, but this is the way. Subhanallah. So Allah Azza wa Jal, he is saying, هَلْ جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا الْإِحْسَانِ. So if that person dies, Allah can punish him, Allah can forgive him. That's the initial. What if Allah forgive him? He's in Jannah. And this is rahmah of Allah. What if Allah punish him? He will go to hellfire. But then he will come out from hellfire. With the rahmah also of Allah Azza wa Jal. Why? Because he feared Allah initially. But he did not act upon it. So the acting part that he did not do, he's punished physically in hellfire for. Then the faith, the root of faith, gets him out to Jannah. But you cannot bypass that and enter Jannah. Okay? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after that, of Surah Yunus, Allah Azza wa Jal said, لَلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا الْحُسْنَ وَزِيَادَةً. Allah Azza wa Jal will give extra even by seeing him himself, subhanahu wa ta'ala, by seeing Allah himself, subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeing the face of Allah, that is the extra level of ihsan. In Jannah, Allah mentioned first the residence, then Allah mentioned the food and the dress and where they're sitting, then Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned the spousal relationship. فهذا كله ترتيب يعني سبحان الله ترتيب in order. Then Allah Azza wa Jal said there is another layer under that. ومن دونهما جنتان. يعني this is the two Jannah is high. But some people they did not reach with their amal that high, but they are still in Jannah. ومن دونهما جنتان. Lower level يعني. مدهامتان. مدهامتان يعني very dark in color. You know when you get to a forest that has lots of foliage and the trees dense, it looks very dark. Dark green. And that's the meaning of مدهامتان. مدهامة جنة مدهامة يعني all these leaves and all, like you go to the Amazon or something like that, you feel density of color. If you are looking from above, you see like dark green. Yes. Yeah, there's very, you know, luscious, like, you know, foliage. It's huge. طبعاً دهمة, it's like dark black. So they are dark green to the point that you see as if it's dark night. فيهما عينان نضاختان, pumping water up. يعني you see there's some spring of water, but the water is coming, flowing easily. Like, this one is like bringing the water, gushing the water out. نضاختان Then it has fakiha. The other one Allah said, from every fruit there is two types. Here Allah said fakiha, general fruit, wa nakhl, palm trees, wa rumman, pomegranate. Subhanallah, pomegranate and dates are fruits. So Allah Azza said, فِي مَفَكِهَ, that's it. Why نَخْلُ وَرُمَّانِ? Because those have fadl. يعني the date palm tree is not like any other fruit. You tell a person who knows يعني palm trees, tell him this fruit, that fruit, and there is dates. Oh, there is date palm tree, barakah, with dates, with different types, all of that. It has, like, you have lots of food, but some food commodities, they have value more than others. Like you say, milk. You know, go get the groceries and milk. Well, milk is a grocery, but because milk is like has an importance here. يعني, something you cannot compensate with other things. Nothing can replace it. Yeah. So Allah Azza wa Jalla says, فيهما فاكهة ونخل ورمان. Well, some of the scholars said, because of the nakhil, يعني the palm tree, it is a fruit, but it is nutrition. The pomegranate is fruit, but it's medicine. So the Arab knew that. And now they are discovering more. Subhanallah, the date, food and nutrition. Fakiha, it's fruit, يعني something like extra, you enjoy, like dessert. But it has nutrition in it. يعني people can live on dates and water for a while. And they can make things out of date. Make date with butter, date with flour, date with milk, date with this, this with that. You can live on that. Rumman, you're not going to live on rumman. But it's fakiha, yani some fruit, you enjoy it. But it has medicine. It has medicine even in its peel. For the skin and for the hair and for the stomach and everything. Everything about the pomegranate has medicine in it. And now it's been discovered yani, more and more. Then Allah Azza wa Jal said, فيهن خيرات حسان. Again, female. Talking about الحور العين. خيرات حسان. يعني حسنة. يعني beautiful in the looks. خيرات in the manners. خير يعني. خيرات حسان. They have good manners and their faces look good as well. وحور is the plural of حوراء. حور مقصورات في الخيام. يعني they also look in the, they are in their tents waiting for their spouses. حور حوراء means the whiteness of the eye is so white and the blackness is so black. And their eyes so, mashallah, beautiful and big. And they are hidden in their, in the other one, they don't look except their husband. Here they are hidden from everyone else. So there are two things to put together. Khayma is the tent. Khayma is the tent. Tent means there are four pillars and there is a pillar in the middle and you put like whatever cloth or something. And then they put above it also like some brushes and some leaves and something like that. But al-khiba, they take it from the skin of the animal, from the camel or from the sheep or from the goat and the cow and all that. Come on, in Jannah, it is not made of cloth or it is made of Allah created, you know, pearls for to be a pearl to become a khayma, yani, something different. Also, those hur al-'ayn, they are there for those people only. Nobody touched them before and nobody will touch them after except the person that Allah blessed him with those. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla said they are reclining on beautiful. Rafraf is the pillows. Now you go to the store, they tell you this pillow is cool gel and this pillow is memory foam and this pillow will make you dream better or this pillow will make you sleep faster. Subhanallah. فالله عز وجل you know, Allah عز وجل said, you know, رفرف خضر يعني green in color. وعبقري حسان يعني those side pillows, side pillows that it has colorful embroideries in it and all of that. Then at the end Allah عز وجل said تبارك اسم ربك ذي الجلال والإكرام. Glory be to Allah Azza wa Jal, the one who has Jalal, all the dignity, and Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who have Ikram, generosity, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Remember, Allah Azza wa Jal, you cannot outdo Allah in His Ihsan. You cannot outdo Allah in His Ihsan. Everything you do is invested for you. Why? Because Allah Zul Jalal, dignity. He does not need our work. Well, Ikram, we are never going to be more generous than Allah. With Allah Himself. يعني, you are not going to be generous, more generous than Allah with His creation. With yourself. You are not more generous to yourself than Allah with you. You are not more generous with anybody than Allah Azza wa Jal with that somebody. How about you with Allah? You're going to be more generous with Allah? لا, طبعا. Of course, Allah is the most generous of all. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who have generosity in our deeds for ourselves. May Allah make us do the ihsan for His sake subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah bless us with this jannat al-na'im. Wa salli allahumma wa sallim wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Wa alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum.